Hey, it's a brand new day. Let's go see if it's daylight yet. Okay, I think we're getting pretty close. It looks like the sun's coming up and it's a beautiful day. Just so you know, there is a little bit of danger when you first exit your hobbit hole in the morning. The googlies are not all dead. When the sun comes up, many of them will burn up, and that's when it's safe to come out. But you know, I'm going to go ahead and jump out here, and if we encounter one, we're not so far along that, you know, I'm going to be crushed at anything I lose. So it looks like, oh, we have a skeleton right over here, see him? We have one right up there, see him? Right now they don't see me yet. If he sees me, he'll start shooting at me. So I'm going to head over here. Oh, there's a spider. Now the good news for me is spiders during the day are typically not real aggressive. I'm gonna give him a wide berth just in case. But yeah, it seems like he's okay with me right now. So there's my hobbit hole right over there. Just you know, I'm hardwired not to want to be okay with the spiders. There's just something about a spider, right? Okay, so it is a new day, and I need some resources. I need some trees. I need some more wood to get busy. I can go mining if I've got the right materials. I am going to burn up my... Oh, hello. Did you hear him? Now, if he comes out in the daylight, he's going to burn up. So I suspect he's right down here in this hole. Oh, yeah, there he is. Now I have the upper hand, so you know what? Let's go ahead and show you what it takes to kill one. Let's put my sword out. Let's get a little closer. Okay, now you always want to have the upper hand, obviously. He's trying to stay in the shade. Let's see if we can't... there we go. Got the achievement. That's good news. So, where possible, I try to avoid the monsters. It's just, you know, it's just safer that way. But sometimes you don't have a choice. So you can't be afraid to go after them, kids. Just, you know, keep your head. Don't panic. Don't jerk your hand around a whole bunch, and you'll do okay. Now I need to take my own advice. I need to do as I say, not as I normally do, which is, you know, I'm a girl. I'm scared. Monsters scare me. I want to run away. So, there we go. Let's go grab a little bit of this wood. And then I want to do a little bit of exploring. With the wood, I can, you know, I can make some additional tools. I can have some spares, which I definitely like having. I kind of the NASA belief system. Two is one. One is none. If I'm down to one tool, that's the same as having none to me. Because that tool could break at a really crucial time for me. And, you know, you really don't want to be stuck somewhere and you don't have a tool. So I like to have spares. Let me just knock a few more trees down. I'll be right back. Okay, I've got a couple of trees cut down. So one thing I am going to do is I'm going to run back to the hidey hole for just a second. I'm going to craft a couple more tools. I'm going to maybe throw a door on this hobbit hole. So, you know, I mean, that won't stop the zombies necessarily, but it will slow them down. So we'll see what we can do with that. I just need, come on, let it go. Do that. And with this, I will make a chest. A chest will hold some of my goodies, so I don't have to go out into the world with everything that I own and potentially lose it. I am going to, like I said, make a couple of more tools. Gonna need some more wood. So there's my second axe. I need some more some more sticks. So we'll do that. That should give me four more. That's five. Well, you know, let's do a little bit more. Again, you can never have too many sticks. I got plenty of torches to begin with, but again, I'm okay with having more. More is never a bad thing. I got a chest, I got a couple of tools. Let's go ahead and make a second sword. And then let's go explore our environment a little bit. Let's find out how close I am to, you know, any major resources. I have enough inventory slots. I do. So I'm going to tear down my furnace. Oh, I was going to make a door. I did not make a door. Here we go. Take 6 pieces of wood. You get 3 doors out of that. Let's go ahead and knock this down now with the axe. And I should probably... You know what I am? I'm going to leave the chest here with most of my stuff. Go ahead and put up... let's see, half my sticks. Because, you know... Maybe half the wood. Half of this wood. Half my meat. I have some pork chops and some steak, so I'll leave the steaks here. Okay, I've got my torch. I'll take that with me just in case I need it. I'm gonna put all but one of these in the shed. So I have some resources when I come back, and I'm gonna just put a door right here. Okay, and a couple of torches to mark where I'm at so I can find it in the dark. Now let's go see what we've got going on out here. One easy way to do that is to grab a shovel, dig up some dirt, and build that nerd pole I was telling you about. And since this is my home base, I think I'm gonna go ahead and do that. So let me just grab a little dirt. And you know, if I can't leave tonight, you know, today, that's okay. I'd rather be prepared before I go exploring. I'd rather have everything I need. I'm also going to take some of this dirt, and I'm going to kind of build a little hut over the place where I spawned in. Now, my reason for doing that is something I saw in a video, which I found very interesting. If you die before you have slept in a bed, your bed is still up. If you die while you're out in the world, when you respawn, you'll come back in exactly the same spot you spawned into the world. Well, that means... Oops, I left a couple. That means that potentially, you know, I'm starting all over, right? So I want to come in, I want to be a little bit protected, but one thing I have found, and I found this out the hard way, is if you put a man-made structure around you, you won't respawn there. So I am going to drop a little dirt around me, and my hope is this time it'll stay. Let's do this. I find it very much easier to move around on the PC. Let's see. Let's go ahead and drop one so I can jump up on it. And go ahead and give myself a little bit of a roof here. Maybe one like that. So I'm, you know, your character is too high. So I can't stand up if it's any more than too high. So that's too high, and if I spawn back in right here, I am protected at least from, you know, initially being seen. And maybe a torch. I don't know. We're going to find out together, okay, what effect this has. So, let's go do a little exploring. I've got a forest out here behind me. That's good. Some low hills. And what I am going to put a torch on the back side just in case. I need to see it from the other direction. What is going on here? It would not let me put that torch up through that grass. Isn't that interesting? Okay, this is as good a place as any. I'm just going to build this up a little bit. I'm going to go too wide. Jump in place. Jump in place. Just back and forth. This is going to give me a bird's eye view, and at the same time it's also going to give me a beacon that I'm going to be able to see from out a distance. And if I put a torch on top of it, I'll be able to see it in the night. And that's going to come in handy if I... Oh, look right there. Boy, did I get lucky. That's a village. A village has resources. A village has... gardens that I can raid, a blacksmith that might have some goods that I'll need. Now it looks like my hut's right here, my little spawn point. My hobbit hole is here. I've got a desert to my right, low hills, lots of plains, and a village. So I'm gonna drop my torch, I'm going to grab my shovel, and I'm going to dig my way down, and I'm going to go check out that village. This is really good news. Okay, I'm taking a bearing. We're just going to run over to the village. Look at these flowers. Wonder what we can do with those. I don't know. We'll find out later. Oh, the village is really pretty close. It didn't take long to get here at all. Now, that means two things. That means that the villagers are at risk. Because of my presence, the mobs, the creatures, they're going to be attracted to this area. And that's not ego talking. That's just, you know, they're attracted to you, the player. So one of the things I'm going to do is I'm going to need to be here at night to protect these guys. I'm going to need to wait for them to get inside, and then I'm going to need to block them in. Otherwise, the zombies will come to this area. Oh, look, he just went inside. I can block him in. There we go. He's not going to be able to get out. Oh, no wonder they're running for the doors. It's nighttime. Now here's a little place I can borrow if I need it. Let's see what we got going in here. We got a few villagers. You can talk to them. They have trades that they'll do for you. So I don't want anything to happen to these guys. So what I'm going to do is close this door, and I'm going to block them in. Oops. Sorry about that. Okay. I'm putting myself at risk here, and I did not bring a spare door with me. So I either need to hold up for the night. Let's see what we have here. Or potentially, you know, fight my way through this. So it's too late. Here come the googlies. Alright, let's do what we can to protect some of these poor villagers. Come on down. Oh, why won't it let me down? Really? There we go. Okay, so this is good to know. This is where I can run into and drop some dirt right in front of the door. That'll protect me. Let's see if there's anybody else I need to protect. Oh. I'm going to need a hole to protect him. Now I'll let him out in the morning. Or frankly, you know, I may leave him right there and let him out when I need something from him. Okay. That sounds cruel, I know. Let's make sure there's nobody coming up on me. This is my hidey hole. Who is this guy? You know what? I need, okay. Well. Sword back out. You know what I'm not seeing is the googlies, and I'm kind of shocked, really. They're normally out by now. Oh, there's a little baby zombie. Let's, you gotta protect yourself from those guys. They are small and fast. I've got a light in here that'll keep them from spawning in here. Oh. See, they like to sound like little sheep. Okay, so I think I've protected most of the villagers. He's going to try to get in there. He's not having a lot of success. So I'm just going to sit here and wait out the night. I'll pause the video and be right back with you. Okay, it's raining, and I've had to eat, and I want to show you a couple of your enemies. That little green thing that just walked by, that was a creeper. He senses my presence, so he's been attracted to this house. And if he should get close enough to me, he'll do a little shake, and then he'll explode. And he will potentially blow a hole right in this wall, so I kind of want to stay out of his view. Look, I have a spider right over there up in the garden beds, and the creeper is circling me, and unfortunately the creepers don't burn up at that during the day. Neither do the spiders. Now, the spiders do go a bit docile, but the creepers can sneak up on you at any time. Now, I've been watching this pair of little baby zombies over here. They are really messing with the villagers here. They want in pretty bad. But as the sun comes up, they'll burn up. The problem is, it's raining. So the sun's not really going to come up enough to burn them up. So they're gonna get to stay out a bit longer. Uh-oh. Looks like one of the... Uh-oh. The zombies are coming after the... I need to go save this guy. Grab my... I have the wrong tool for the job. Good grief. When I hear the creeper. Oh, he turned one of the... Oh, my goodness. He turned one of the villagers into a zombie. You could tell because he's got the bigger nose. Now, these guys are little and they're fast and... Oh, my goodness. And I did see... Where'd that creeper go? Oh, there he is. Oh, run. So when they get too close to you, and I'm going to see if I can't make him blow up. Okay, come here. Knock him back, and boom, there he goes. Okay, now I could have knocked him back a bit further. I put my hand on the wrong key. On the PC, you use the double W to run, and or the control key, and I missed it. But yeah, that's what a creeper does. And that's how you fight him. So he's gone. There were two of them. Oh, here comes a zombie. Again, it's raining, so they're not really dying. You know, they'll burn up in the daylight, but we don't have a whole lot of sun, so I've got to keep my eye open. So I'm going to go clear the village of all the zombies and the bad guys. And, you know, I'm going to go ahead and kill the spider. Let's get up here. There's something called a critical hit, and with that, you jump. And if at the same time you jump, you come down with the sword, you'll be able to get a critical hit on an enemy. And that makes it a little more effective. Okay. So it took fewer hits to kill him, with one of them being a critical hit. So I was able to pick up... oh, did I lose it? Did he not give me string? String is one of the byproducts of the spider. It looks like I... Oh my goodness, okay. See, the sun's coming out, they're starting to burn. Now, if I get the last hit on him, I get the experience points. If he dies as a result of burning up, I don't get any experience points. So, okay. I've saved a few of the villagers, not all of them, unfortunately. And I have found some wheat. I can use this wheat to make bread. Now, I'm not going to clean them out. Not all this wheat is ready. Oh, carrots. I'm going to dig these up because I need to replant these. And what is this? Wheat? It's not ready. I hate to do it, but I'm gonna pick these up. They're not quite ready, which means, you know, when they're ready, they've got a bit more to grow. But if I use one of these carrots that I just picked up, I can replant... And give them something to grow. So let's go ahead and do a few of these. I want to be able to use this when I come back. This is really close. So I'll keep this growing for myself. What do you trade, sir? He trades wheat for emeralds. If I give him 18 wheat, he'll give me an emerald. Okay, and there's a little wheat ready there. Now, I've got some seeds here. Seeds are what you plant to get wheat. And you get seeds, oddly enough, by knocking down grass. You go through the tall grass, and you can get some seeds. Obviously, you get seeds also from harvesting wheat. So that's it. I've got a few little resources. I hate to bring danger to the villagers anymore, so I'm going to go back to my hobbit hole. I'm going to tool up. And I'm going to go mining. This is not the way I came in, is it? But what is that? Let's see what we have down here. Do we have a villager in here? What we have is an empty house. That's good to know. It means if I need to come in, spend the night while I'm out wandering around, I can do so. Again, I do want to go ahead and replant. Only because I'm going to be depending on this garden as much as they will. Now, if I leave them alive and I get them out, I clear out all the zombies. Is there no door in this place? Good grief. What happened to the door? Oh, another place that I can use. Okay, good to know. So if I clear them all out, okay, so I think it's time to head back to my hobbit hole, bake some bread, get a few supplies ready to go mining. When you're mining, you're going to burn through a lot of calories. You're going to need a lot of food. So that was one of the reasons I went ahead and grabbed some of that wheat. I am going to need some of that. I also want to protect this villager. Let me make sure there is somebody in there. Good grief. No, it looks like this may have been the villager that the zombies got. And this... Oop, close the door in my face. That's nobody. This village is a bit bigger than most. I've got about half of them protected. The other half are out wandering around. I'm not real sure why they're doing that. Is that everybody? Did I get everybody? I'm really disappointed to see there's no black shops, a blacksmith. A lot of times they'll have chests that you can raid. Boy, that rain was loud, wasn't it? Who's in here? Nobody? Okay, already it's getting dark again. Okay, we're heading home. We're gonna go bake some bread. We're going to go get tooled up, and then we'll do some mining. I'll fast forward through this and connect with you guys in just a minute. Okay. I can't miss an opportunity like this. I mean, coal is just sitting out here in this little pond. This is also an opportunity to talk about some of the other ways you can die. You can drown. Do you see the bubbles over there counting down? When they get to the bottom, I'll begin drowning. And if I don't have full hearts, it won't take me very long. So one of the things you want to do is keep an eye on that. You'll also notice right below the bubbles are what I call the meat sickles. The meat sickles indicate hunger. And when you're hungry, you don't rejuvenate. One of the things you want to do is make sure you stay fed, so you stay healthy. And you can do that with cow, lamb, pig, baking bread, eating carrots, baking potatoes. I mean, you have a lot of options. You just need to make sure you stay on top of that. Now, if you'll remember, before I left to go to the village, I did cook some pork chops. I had to eat one of them while I was in the village. Because my food bar, my meat sickles were getting smaller. So I did do that. And now I'm going to set up my crafting table and my furnace and bake some of this wheat up and set some aside for replanting. I'm going to get tooled up and then we'll go mining. So we'll do that in the next video. Let me just rebuild my health or my food bar here. We'll do that in the next video, so stay tuned. I'm going to show you my preferred mining technique. Now, this initial foyer will just be to go in and find some iron. We want to upgrade our tools. Iron is better than stone. We need some iron, so I'm going to be on a mission to find some iron and get started with our mining operations. I also need to find a place to live, a place to build, kind of a home base. I don't think that I'm there. But I might be. But in order to know, I need to take a look around and see what my other options are. So this is the Geeky Minecrafter signing off. Till next time, happy mining!